have been hearing about today? The love of God. Is that right?
Yes.
And Brother Yulanda has been teaching us today what? What did he teach us about today in this afternoon? If you know that God loves you, if you know God loves you, then who is he to you? You know that God loves you, right?
Yes.
We all children of God. When? When we believed in Jesus. Is that right? Now, because we know that God loves us, the question that he posed, that Jesus posed to each of his disciples, he says, who am I to you? I love you. But if I love you, who am I to you? Like a husband will ask to his wife, who am I to you? You're my husband. What are you asking this question? And a wife asked to a husband asked to his wife, who are you to me? I'm your wife. No, you're my Valentine. You're my sweetheart. You're my kuchu kuchu. You're my kuku kuku. Now you understand what I'm saying? But if you say, you're my husband, you're my wife. That is why Jesus asked the question, who am I to you? I know I'm Messiah. I know I'm Lord. I know I'm the King of Kings. I know I'm the Lord of Lords. I know I'm the healer. I'm all that. But to you personally, who am I? And that's what Brother Yulanda asked the question, what Jesus asked his disciples. At this point in time, I want to take you a little bit further now. This God loves us, right? You have no doubt about it. Now I'm going to take one aspect. One of my brothers asked me, he said, share about this. And I think it is so much connected with God's love. What are we going to celebrate next Wednesday? To remind us that God loves us. Isn't it?
Yes.
Just because I said, because it reminded you? Yes. To remind you what? Is next Wednesday you're going to remind yourself when the father puts ashes on your head and says, God loves me, put ashes on me. You're going to turn into ashes. That is what he's going to say when he's going to put the ashes. Correct? Is that going to inspire you? You say, put knife, lipstick, anything, white hair is coming, let me paint it. And this father is saying, dust are thou, dust you shall turn into. And then you'll hear on the day the reading. When you fast, go into room, put nice oil on. Even if you don't put oil, coconut oil, on that day put coconut oil. Even if you don't put oil on your head, only on Ash Wednesday you'll put oil. So that everybody will know that you look smart. And then when you pray, don't pray like with everybody. Go into a room and pray. You'll hear all that reading on that day. Is that right? And then he says, when you fast, what did he say? What happens when you fast? What did you say? Yeah, we have to be cheerful when we fast. Because right now we had a nice cup of tea with biscuits. So we are very cheerful. Correct? Let me ask you a question. Why do we fast? Because God loves us so much. God, because you love us so much, I can fast for you. Correct? Anyone disagrees with that? If someone loves you so much, can't you give up food for him? I'm asking you a question. You don't want to answer me?
Yes.
Was the tea not good? I'll have to complain to the guy to put more sugar next time. If God loves you, when he says you have to fast, don't you need to fast?
Yes.
Okay, let's read this, what it says. Matthew 9:14. Look at this now. No, Matthew 9:14. Then the disciples of John came to him saying, why do we and the Pharisees fast often, but your disciples do not
fast?
Whose disciples?
Jesus'
disciples. Then, 15. And Jesus said to them, can the friends of the bridegroom mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them? Brother Yulander talked about the church. Who's the church? Who's the groom? And who's the bride? We are the bride, the church, all of us. The friends of the bridegroom mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them. Now read this carefully, all together. But the days will come when the bridegroom will be taken away from them, and then they will fast. Does Jesus love you?
Yes.
Did he tell you that he'll be taken away one day?
Yes.
Was he taken away?
Yes.
Did he say when he's taken away we will fast?
Yes.
You love Jesus?
Yes.
Does Jesus love you?
Yes.
That means you have to
fast.
How many of you are fasting only on Ash Wednesday? Only on Ash Wednesday, how many are fasting?
Friday.
And Good Friday also. And once a week. Once a week. Who's fasting twice a week? Twice a week. That's why you are nice, slim and trim. How many are fasting every day? You fast every day? 40 days? You actually don't take anything for 40 days? Or you eat after sunset? So as soon as the sun sets, you eat. When the sun is up, you don't eat. There is no? Okay. See, the Holy Spirit knows exactly to give us a topic. God loves us so much. Isn't it?
Yes.
God loves us so much.
Yes.
He loves us unconditionally. Did he send Jesus?
Yes.
And this brother and this sister, all of them, they are fasting. Because they believe in Jesus' word. He says, when the bridegroom will be taken away from them, and then they will fast. They are taking exactly the scripture. You are fasting because of this word, right, brother? Why are you fasting? Come, brother, just come 1 minute. Since you are fasting every day, you are the perfect example for us. Come. This brother, you have been fasting every day.
All 40 days.
All 40 days. You know how many people only fasted for 40 days? Elijah, Moses, and Jesus. On the Bible, there are three people. And today we know.
What's your name?
And Brother Manuel is the fourth. He fasts for 40 days. Isn't this wonderful? Can we give the Lord a round of applause for our Brother Manuel? Now, and you, sister? Come. You also come, please. Come. Please come. Please come. Please come. I need you to come here because we are all going to learn from you all. What's your name, sister? Aapka naam kya hai?
Jacqueline.
Jacqueline. Sister Jacqueline or Brother Manuel, dono 40 days fast karte hain length mein. Aiye, ye side mein aiye. Okay. I want to ask you, brother, sister, main aapko puchna chahta hoon, aap 40 days fasting kyon karte hain?
Aatmik unnati ke liye.
Le lo, mic lo.
आप कौन सी भाषा में बोलिए, no problem. जो भाषा आपको पसंद है, जो आपको समझ में आता है, वो बोलो.
आत्मिक उन्नति के लिए.
आत्मिक उन्नति के लिए. Where is my brother Yolanda? Can you translate to me?
Spiritual.
Spiritual growth के लिए. Very good. Very good. That's a good answer. Brother, what about you?
I want to leave my all the bad habits.
You want to leave all the bad habits?
Bad habits.
Okay. So when you fast, you will able to leave all the bad habits?
Yeah.
How many years you've been fasting 40 days during length?
It's almost 7 to 8 years.
More 7 to 8 years, yeah. In length, you don't eat at all?
Yeah. Only after evening.
Only after sunset?
Sunset.
That means you probably around take only eight, one meal?
Yeah. 8 or 9 o'clock somewhere.
8 to 9 o'clock? Every day?
Evening, yeah. After coming from the work.
Praise God.
Only tea. And then.
Sister, next year when we call, probably you'll also be joining us. Uh, ओके नाउ यू अब सिस्टर बोली कि मेरे क्या एग्जैक्ट टर्म क्या बोला
आत्मिक
आत्मिक उन्नति के लिए जरा थोड़ा और एक्सप्लेन कर सकते हैं आत्मिक उन्नति का मतलब क्या है थोड़ा और थोड़ा बताइए क्या क्या होता है आत्मिक उन्नति में
वर्ड ऑफ गॉड
हाँ क्या होता है
वचन में आगे बढ़ना चाहिए
वचन में आगे बढ़ना चाहिए मतलब
आप जो
थोड़ा थोड़ा आगे रखिए क्योंकि
जो वचन पढ़ते हैं हम
ओके
वो बार बार आपके दिमाग में लेकर उसको बढ़ते रहना चाहिए
तो ये जो वचन पढ़ती है ये जो फास्टिंग करने के बाद क्या होता है वचन से
आत्मिक उन्नति होती है जिससे ग्रोथ
मुझे थोड़ा समझाइए मतलब आत्मिक उन्नति बोलेगी तो मुझे क्लियर नहीं समझता थोड़ा एक्सप्लेन करो क्योंकि सबको समझना चाहिए आप ये तो जो आप कर रही है बहुत अच्छा कर रही है लेकिन ये जो आप टर्म यूज़ किया आत्मिक उन्नति ये तो सही है लेकिन थोड़ा उसका एक्सप्लेनेशन दीजिए
तो समझ में नहीं आ रहा
मतलब और थोड़ा उसका आपको हमको सबको मतलब दीजिए ये आत्मिक उन्नति से क्या होता है आपको
मुझे
थोड़ा माइक आगे रखिए
मुझे अच्छा लगता है कि ये उपवास करने के बाद कि मैं ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा वर्ड ऑफ गॉड को पढ़ते जाऊँ और उसमें अपना ध्यान अपना मन लगाते जाओ और दूसरों को भी बोलूँ कि ये सब आप करते जाओ
दूसरों का क्या बोलेगी
ये वर्ड ऑफ गॉड के बारे में
तो अगर आप फास्टिंग नहीं करेगी तो आप दूसरे को वर्ड नहीं बता सकती
बता सकते
तो
लेकिन
आप
अंदर से अच्छा ये आता है क्या
अंदर से क्या होता है
स्ट्रांग फीलिंग आता है
अंदर से स्ट्रांग फीलिंग आता है अगर फास्टिंग करेगा तो स्ट्रांग फीलिंग नहीं आएगा
आता है
नहीं मुझे पूछना है मुझे समझना है सबको समझना कि फास्टिंग करने के बाद ये स्ट्रांग फीलिंग होता है फास्टिंग नहीं करेगा तो स्ट्रांग फीलिंग नहीं होता है ऐसा भी है
नहीं
तो फास्टिंग करेगा और नहीं करेगा स्ट्रांग फीलिंग
आता है
तो फास्टिंग का क्या आई डोंट नो समबडी आस्क्ड अ क्वेश्चन आई थिंक यस्टरडे वी हैड अ बिजी मीटिंग समबडी व्हाट इज द पर्पस ये जो आप कर रहे हैं उसका कारण क्या है उसका वजह क्या है अगर हम कुछ भी करते हैं जिंदगी में उसके लिए कुछ वजह रहेगी है कि नहीं देयर शुड बी अ रीजन देयर शुड बी अ पर्पस देयर शुड बी अ गोल फॉर विच रीजन वी आर फास्टिंग दिस सिस्टर सेज आत्मिक उन्नति के लिए ना आत्मिक उन्नति के लिए ये आत्मिक उन्नति बढ़ाना है तो मुझे फास्टिंग करना है कि नहीं तो मुझे समझना है ये आत्मिक उन्नति से क्या है जिस प्रभु यीशु बोलता है कि जब वो जाएंगे तो हम सबको फास्टिंग करना है कि नहीं इसलिए वो प्रभु यीशु का वचन देख के ये भाई और ये मेरे बहन फास्टिंग करते हैं तो आत्मिक उन्नति से क्या होता है ये थोड़ा बताइए सबको क्योंकि आप लोग 7-8 साल के एक्सपीरियंस लोग हैं 40 दिन फास्टिंग करते हैं ये बहुत बड़ी चीज है तो मुझे समझना है ब्रदर आप यू कैन टेल मी इंग्लिश हिंदी
आई टोल्ड यू ना आई एम ट्राइंग टू लीव माय ऑल द बैड हैबिट्स
सो यू आर डूइंग इट टू लीव योर बैड हैबिट्स बाय फास्टिंग यू आर एबल टू लीव योर बैड हैबिट्स नाउ फॉर द लास्ट 7-8 इयर्स यू हैव बीन फास्टिंग हैव यू बीन एबल टू लीव योर बैड हैबिट्स
No, not yet. This year I have promised to God that I'll leave all the bad habits. I am having only one habit of smoking.
Smoking. So 7-8 years you have been fasting for 40 days during Lent to break your bad habits. Is that right?
Yeah.
But this year is probably
last 7-8 years I have not promised to myself.
You're not.
Now I have promised to God.
Yeah. So 7-8 years you have been fasting and to give your bad habits, but you hope this year you will be able to do it.
Yeah, I have.
Praise God. Now, sister, आप बोली मेरे को आत्मिक उन्नति आप आत्मिक उन्नति से आपको क्या फायदा होता है ये मुझे बताइए ना ओके मुझे मैं पूछूंगा जब आप फास्टिंग करते हैं आपको अच्छा फीलिंग होता है प्रभु यीशु आपको दुआ ज्यादा दुआ देता है जब फास्टिंग करते हैं ज़्यादा दुआ देता है वेरी गुड आपको आपके परिवार को ज़्यादा आशीर्वाद देता है ना डिड शी से दैट शी सेज दैट शी इज फास्टिंग बिकॉज शी विल बी ब्लेस्ड मोर ब्रदर इज फास्टिंग बिकॉज ही वॉन्ट्स टू ब्रेक अ बैड हैबिट इज दैट राइट इज एनी वन गॉट एनी आंसर हियर अदर देन दैट हाँ सिस्टर बोलिए, आइए पुष्पा जी आइए, आगे आइए आगे आइए।
ब्रदर, जैसा कि आप पूछ रहे हैं कि 40 दिन का उपवास जो हम करते हैं क्यों करते हैं, तो हम इसलिए 40 दिन उपवास रखते हैं जिस तरह हमारे प्रभु यीशु ने 40 दिन उपवास रख के पहाड़ पर जब वो थे अकेले प्रार्थना कर रहे थे तो शैतान उनके पास उनकी परीक्षा लेने आता है, तो उस समय वो शैतान को फटकारते हैं क्योंकि उनके अंदर शक्ति होती है पिता ईश्वर की। उसी याद में हम उनके दुख को याद करते हुए वो 40 दिन का उपवास रखते हैं जिससे हमें अंदर से शक्ति मिलती है हर तरह के बंधन और शैतान की जो भी बहकावे हैं, प्रलोभन हैं जो शैतान हमें देता है उससे लड़ने की ताकत हमारे अंदर उपवास के कारण आता है और वचन में विश्वास और बढ़ता है हमारा।
ओके okay. अभी सिस्टर बोली, brother bola, brother said that he fasts because he wants to get over bad habit. Sister said she wants to get blessed more. This sister Pushpa said that she's fasting because of what? Because Jesus fasted, he was able to encounter the devil and successfully defeat the devil. So in memory of that, so that just like by fasting we also will get strength to fight the devil, she also is fasting fasting. Is that right?
जी.
जैसा प्रभु यीशु ने किया, तो फास्टिंग करने के बाद आपको ज्यादा शक्ति आएगी, है ना
जी?
कौन सी शक्ति आएगी?
प्रभु यीशु,
प्रभु यीशु की शक्ति आएगी। अब ऐसे बोले ना
जी,
इफ यू फास्ट। ओके, आप सब बैठिए, नो प्रॉब्लम। थैंक यू। कैन वी गिव दिस सिस्टर्स एंड ब्रदर्स अ राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर व्हाट दे आर डूइंग। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू द सिंपल ट्रुथ व्हाई यू नीड टू डू फास्टिंग। We heard three answers today. I did not get anybody coming here and telling me we fast because we want to become slim and trim. कोई नहीं आगे आया बोला मेरा वजन बहुत बड़ा है। देखो मेरे को दिखेगा तो मेरा वजन कम होना चाहिए। एक्चुअली मैंने भी जवाब देना चाहिए कि आई ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू लूज वेट, देयरफॉर आई डू फास्टिंग। इफ आई डू फास्टिंग फॉर अबाउट 5-10 days, आई प्रॉमिस यू माई वाइफ विल टेल यू आई विल लूज वेट वेरी फास्ट। So one person fasts because he wants to get over bad habit, Brother Manuel. Our sister Pushpa said that she is fasting because she wants the same strength of Jesus. And our sister Jacqueline, she said that she fasts because she wants to get dua, blessings. Is that right? Now listen to this. Listen to this. Whether you fast, listen to this again, huh? And don't be upset with me what I tell you. Whether you fast or you don't fast. I said what? Whether you fast or you don't fast, God is not upset with you. You're not going to get anything from God whether you fast for one day, 40 days or every day. Why are you all quiet? Today I put a big, if you had a big balloon of fasting, I put one pin there and I burst your balloon. Because you have been under the impression, हम सबको इतना हमने सीखा है कि fasting से हमको प्रभु यीशु ज्यादा दुआ देगा, ज्यादा शक्ति देगा। हो हमारा जो क्या है bad habits है, जो बुरी आदत है हमारी वो दूर करेगा, राइट ब्रदर मैनुअल? बट डू यू नो व्हाई यू फास्ट? व्हाई डू यू फास्ट? इफ यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू गेट एनीथिंग फ्रॉम गॉड बाय फास्टिंग, इवन इफ यू ईट ऑन एश वेनसडे, डोंट टेल फादर। इफ यू ईट ऑन एश वेनसडे, गॉड इज नॉट अपसेट विथ यू। On Good Friday, even if you eat, most of you, I know you eat that, but you come there, you're fasting, man. You had hot cross bun, man. I had only tea and bun. I never had lunch today, but I had tea and bun. I drink tea. As soon as the services go to have masala dosa. Correct? Ash Wednesday, After the ashes are put, I'll go for evening service. As soon as the service goes, you know when the Udpi restaurants make maximum profit? On Ash Wednesday and Good Friday. Correct? Right or wrong? All the vegetarian restaurants in Pune, they know that when Catholics have Ash Wednesday and Good Friday, that day they bring all the sabji from Pune and they stock it in their restaurants. Because all the Catholics in Goa, Pune, around the world, go only and eat vegetarian food. Today I'm going to set you free, the Word of God is going to set you free from a big, big stronghold in your mind. Are you ready? If you fast or don't fast, as far as God is concerned, no difference. And yet Jesus says, when the bridegroom will be taken away from them, then they will fast. Was the bridegroom taken away from them? That means when the bridegroom has been taken away from them, they have to fast. Did he say, when the bridegroom will be taken away from them, they must fast or they will fast? Listen to the words. You must remember very clearly what is a must and what has to be done. Okay? So get this thing in your mind. As far as God is concerned, if you want to have your breakfast, lunch and dinner on Ash Wednesday and Good Friday, remember you have not committed a sin. As far as God is concerned. Many of you must be saying, brother, come on, preach now. Abhi bolo, come on, you have given us some good news. I was just thinking, how will manage that Ash Wednesday? How will manage the Good Friday? Now listen to this. The bridegroom was with them. With whom? With the disciples. Is that right? So the bridegroom, in case Peter's mother-in-law was not well, what did they do? Jesus, my mother-in-law is not well. How many of you would ever lay hands on your mother-in-law? Or how many of you would bring somebody to lay hands on your mother-in-law if she's not well? Because you all are believing Jesus, you always bring somebody to pray over your mother-in-law. I said, because you all believe in Jesus, you always call the priest or call somebody when it's not well to pray over your mother-in-law. In the same way, when Peter accepted Christ and he brought Jesus to pray over his mother-in-law. And what happened? Peter's mother-in-law was healed of her fever and she began to serve them. Is that what the Word of God says? Now imagine, Peter's mother-in-law was not well. Say, I don't know if any other disciple got married. Maybe Andrew had some cousin of his was not well. Jesus can be only with Peter's mother-in-law. Can he be there anywhere, other place? He can be only there. Now say Jesus is not there. Now Jesus is not there. Jesus has been taken away. Where? He's gone back to the Father. Now Peter's mother-in-law is not well. How is Peter going to heal his mother-in-law? He's going to heal himself. He himself has to heal Peter's mother-in-law, his own mother-in-law. How? In the name of Jesus. But Peter's mother-in-law this time does not have a fever. She has got a cancer. She has got a very bad cancer. He looks at her and she's looking absolutely sick. At least when Jesus came to him, Peter's mother-in-law could open her eyes. Hello, Jesus. I got fever. No worry. Tong, and she's up there. This time, Peter is watching his own mother-in-law and she's looking. Jesus. And Peter has gone to pray over his mother-in-law. Now he doesn't have Jesus. Now what is happening to Peter? If he had Jesus with him, he said, Jesus, just fix her. Now he has to do the job. But now what he's seeing with his eyes is talking to him loudly because he says, situation is very hopeless. At that time, if he has not trained his mind not to focus on what he's seeing with his eyes, but he has to focus on what Jesus has told him in his word, that in the name of Jesus, he can heal his mother-in-law. For him to change his mindset from what he can see with his eyes to what he should see to the eyes of faith, he requires to have a mindset. He requires to have a mindset which refuses to believe what his senses are telling him. Are you understanding?
Yes.
What he's seeing with his eyes, what he can feel right now in his presence, is so real to him. But he tells his mind, I do not care what I see, I believe what the word says, and Jesus has already healed. So I'll take my authority in Christ, rebuke that sickness. Now, to reach that stage, he has to have a very trained mind. Fasting is a spiritual tool. Fasting is a spiritual tool to train your mind to focus on the word, because when you are not trained in your mind to focus on the word, what you see is going to bring unbelief. I said, you have faith, but you can have a little bit of unbelief, and that unbelief is going to kill your faith. Are you with me?
Yes.
So what is fasting required for? Not for God. Fasting is required for you and me, so that we can train this mind not to focus on our senses, but to focus on the word of God, to focus on the faith, to focus on the unseen, to focus on the spiritual victory that Jesus has already given to us, and not to focus what my eyes are telling, what the doctor's report has said, what I feel, what I smell, what my senses say, but what the word of God has promised me. And that training which I need to have can be done through a spiritual tool. There are many other spiritual, but fasting becomes the quickest and the best method to train this mind. So when I fast, what happens? Jab main upas karta hoon, kya hota hai? Mera dhyan kiske upar jata hai? Mere पेट पे. पेट बोलता है, अरे गुंगू गुंग हो रहा है, चाय दे दो, पानी दे दो, बिस्किट दे दो, बिरयानी दे दो. कल क्या करेगा? कल क्या प्रोग्राम है? छोड़ो, कुछ तो दे दो. लेकिन मैं मेरे मन को बोलता हूं, मन को बोलता हूं कि मेरे पेट से बात करो. पेट को बोला, चुप हो जा, तुमको कुछ नहीं मिलने वाला है. जब मैं दूंगी दूंगा तभी तुमको पेट में कुछ खाना मिलेगा. तब तक बुखार जोर भूखा मर जा. I said, when you tell your mind to tell your stomach, you stomach, shut up, don't make noises. Even if you make your noises, you're going to get nothing. I'm going to train my mind not to be controlled by my sense knowledge, but I'm going to be controlled by a will, by a decision. And when I fast, I'm training this mind to focus on that word and that promise, and not to be focused on my senses. Now I'm going to tell you quickly, because we want to have a healing for you for about 15-20 minutes. You remember Jesus is transfigured on the high mountain? Remember that scripture? Jesus is transfigured up the high mountain, and he's coming down the mountain, and there is a father who's brought his son who has epilepsy to be healed by the disciples. Is that right? The disciples try to cast that demon out. That demon does a little bit of Macarena. You know what is Macarena?
Yes.
Disco. And as soon as the Macarena starts, the disciples also say, "Are kya ho raha hai?" They had already seen the demon being cast out. But this time, the demon wants to do a little bit of a longer dance. The disciples, instead of focusing on the word, immediately their senses tell them, this demon is not going. In the meantime, seeing all this movie taking place, the disciples must have put their hands up and said, ye to bada, bada ye, bada shaitan hai. Looks like this fellow won't come out. Correct? Now the father comes running to Jesus as he comes down. Jesus, I brought my son to your disciples to cast the demon out. and your disciples could not cast the demon out. What does Jesus say to the people? You faithless and perverse generation. Why? Why does he say to the people, you faithless and perverse generation? He has been preaching to them for the last 2 years, 3 years, it was already 2 years. 2 years, they had seen the miracles, he has seen casting out devils, they have seen his glory, yet they are not able to believe the word of God. Correct? So he says, bring the boy to me. Rebukes the devil. The devil throws the boy into a fit, throws him unconscious. He looks like a dead boy, and they say, I think he's dead. Jesus just picks him up, gives him to the father, he's healed, set free, and they go back and they all go home. When they come inside the house, the disciples ask Jesus the question. Now, who's asking the question? Disciples. So disciples ask Jesus the question, Prabhu Yeshu, hum ye shaitan ko kyun hata nahi sake? Why could not we cast that evil spirit out? Because the same disciples had cast the evil spirit out. Do you remember? They were sent out two by two. They seen the glory. And Jesus even said, I saw Satan fall like lightning. They said, in your name we cast out devils, we heal the sick, da 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 da. All that they saw. But this time the evil spirit did not come out. What did Jesus say to them? It is because, did he say because of you, not you don't have faith? But he said, because of your unbelief. What is unbelief? Unbelief is something that becomes, that comes in when you go by your sense knowledge, by what you see. By what you see. But a person who's not going to watch all that movie, you're going to tell the devil, enough drama bas ho gaya, makarana bas ho gaya tumhara. Tumhara natak bahut ho gaya. You have to get out. A person who's, even though he's going to see all that, his focus is not on what he's seeing, his focus is on the end result. So what did Jesus say? It is because of your unbelief. He said, this kind of unbelief can only be driven out by prayer and fasting. He never said this kind of devil will be removed by prayer and fasting. If you try to fast to, and try to cast out the devil, you'll be saying, will you be able to do that? When you want to cast out a devil, eat well and go. Have a good meal and go. I said, next time you want to cast out a devil, please have a good meal and go. Don't go fasting. Non-veg? I said to you, any food. Any food. Why only non-veg? Why only non-veg? Tell me, why only non-veg? See, how many people here have got this concept? On Fridays throughout the year, I eat only vegetarian. Why you eat vegetarian? You know, Jesus died on Good Friday, therefore I eat vegetarian. What are you getting by eating vegetarian or non-veg? No, nothing, but I like to keep vegetarian. What benefit is there? Jesus died. No? What are you going to get benefit? They look at you. What benefit? No, I'll just... Friday, no? Just God is will be happy with me. Eat non-veg, eat chicken, eat a deer also, eat a lion also that day. Are you with me? There's going to be no benefit for you because we have become so religious, we have brought some rules into our head and brains, and we are not following the truth. You are not supposed to fast in order to get anything from God. I just told you, you are fast to train your mind to kill unbelief, to train your mind so that your mind is so trained not to focus on what you see, what your senses are telling you, so that your mind is trained on the word of God. Now I'm going to give you a testimony quickly in 5 minutes. About a month and a half ago, I was called to Nigdi. Here, Nigdi in Pune. Is anybody here from Nigdi? Nobody is here from Nigdi? Okay, the person in Nigdi had a problem with one bone. The lady was about 65 and she had an accident. They had put a rod, so she can't bend her hip. If the rod is there, the hip cannot be bent. Is that right? So they said, please come on, because she's in a lot of pain. So there's a physical healing. I said, okay, you're sending the car. VIPs go by car, right? You're sending me a car, I'll go by car instead of going by train. So they send the car, I went with them. When I reached there, I found out that she had an issue with her daughter-in-law. She prayed for her daughter-in-law, forgave her daughter-in-law, and we started praying for her physical healing. What physical healing? To get this pain out. She was sitting on a chair like this. As soon as I laid my hands upon her to get her physically healed, because she forgave, there was no reason why she could not get healed. As soon as I said, she began to manifest big time. She began to manifest big time. Her eyes turned, only I could see the white. She went sliding down the chair, and for the next 1 hour, she was going like a top and top and top, round, round, round. And she was saying things which you could not understand. It sounded like some Russian language, but I don't know what language she was talking. And she was just talking, eyes closed, and she was just rotating around like a circle. And I'm wondering, what's going on? The people in the house, there were 12 people in the house, they were absolutely scared. Because if it goes for 5 minutes, 10 minutes is fine. But if it goes for about 35, 40 minutes, what is going to happen? There is going to be fear coming. So I told the family members, please be relaxed. These things are a manifestation of an evil spirit in her. What? Now if I had not to train my mind to see, not to focus on what this Makarena is being done by the enemy, would fear come into me? Would fear come into me? But I'm not going to focus on this drama of this move of the enemy. I'm going to focus on the end result to set her free. Is that right? After 45 minutes, the husband comes to me and he says, brother, 15 years ago, I took my wife to a Muslim Baba. I took my wife to a Muslim Baba and he gave her something to drink. I said, praise God, brother. Good you came and told me. Why didn't you tell me 5-10 minutes? At least I would have known that she has gone to the den of the devil. I said, she went to the den of the devil to get the devil out. I mean, can you go to the den of the devil to get the devil out? To whom must you go to get the devil out? To Jesus. You don't go to the Muslim Baba or to a Hindu astrologer or go to some Pandu or Shandu to get a devil out. You're going to actually get the devil in. So she was possessed and she was given something to drink. I said, no problem. Next 15 minutes, my intensified, my authority in Christ, the blood of Jesus, we got that thing out of her. After about almost 1 hour, 10 minutes, she sat up absolutely in a frame of mind and said, thank you very much. I said, no, it's 90% job done. Please give her some water to drink. And I said, bring one bucket, because you're going to see God's glory. So they gave her 2-3 glasses of water. And after she drank the glass, 2 minutes later, she began to puke and puke green and what sorts of color thing. And after about 1.5 hours, she was completely set free. And not only was she set free from the evil spirit, that rod which was straight like this, now she was able to do circus. She's ready for the Olympics. Her body became so flexible. That rod, because of all the movement, which was like this, she was walking like this, now she's walking like this, like a soldier. Don't look at my backside, but that's how she was walking. 2-in-1. Got the evil spirit out, physical healing done, the devil also is out, and she's completely set free. Now my question to you is, if I had not to train this mind of mine, not to focus on all the movie that I'm seeing in front of me, would that manifestation of getting the devil out gone? I'm asking you. No, because the moment you don't know the truth, that you may know the truth, but if you don't know that these things are going to happen and the enemy is going to give his best shot, but when you know the end result in the authority of Christ, that lady, that sister has to be set free. I keep my focus on that end result and I'm not going to let go, because I'm going to, in the name of Jesus, set my sister free. That is why you do fasting, in order to train your mind. So from today, if you ever are doing fasting to get something from God, to break a bad habit, to get more blessing, stop it. I said, stop it. You're not going to get any of those things. And the only thing that you will get if you fast is, you can get a flat stomach, which I need one as well. Don't you think so? Won't I look nice and trim and proper? Some of my trousers which are not fitting also will fit me if I lose some weight. So that is the only benefit apart from the physical. But spiritually, the fasting is a spiritual tool only to train my mind. So is everyone got that? Did you understand the reason of fasting today? Has a stronghold, wrong teaching broken out of your mind? Upas kiske liye karte hum? क्योंकि हमको ये जो मन है हमारा उसको मजबूत बनाने के लिए, क्योंकि जब हम उपास करते हैं ये मन को एक्सरसाइज मिलता है, ट्रेनिंग मिलती है. क्यों, किस कौन से ट्रेनिंग? कि जो मुझे दिखता है, जो मुझे सुनाई देता है, वो मुझे ज़्यादा मेरा ध्यान उसके पर नहीं जाने के लिए, लेकिन फास्टिंग से ये मेरा मन मेरा ट्रेन होता है और मेरा जो मेरा फोकस है, मेरा जो ध्यान है, प्रभु यीशु के वचन पर रहता है. इज दैट ओके? इज दैट फाइन? ओके. नाउ बिफोर वी एंड, वी हैव गॉट एग्जैक्टली 20 मिनट्स. एनी ऑफ यू हियर रिक्वायर एनी फिजिकल हीलिंग? एनी ऑफ यू रिक्वायर फिजिकल हीलिंग? ओके. ओनली वन पर्सन रिक्वायर्स फिजिकल हीलिंग? आई थॉट इफ देयर मेनी पीपल रिक्वायर देन वी हैव टू हैव अ लॉन्गर सर्विस. इफ जस्ट वन और टू पीपल, वी कैन हैव यू हील्ड राइट हियर. हाउ मेनी पीपल रिक्वायर? जस्ट पुट योर हैंड्स अप. How many of you require physical healing? Come on, put your hands up. Okay. If just about 4 or 5 people, I want you to come up in front. Aye, come in front, come in front. Because if it is about almost 10-15 people, then we can have you, you know, pray over each other. If all those who are sick, about 4 or 5, no problem, please come up here. We've got my brother Yolanda, sister Redeema. We'll just have pray, lay hands on you. Now listen to this very carefully. Please come. Aye, aage. Now listen to this very carefully. Is God going to heal them?
Yes.
Listen to my question very carefully. Is God going to heal you? Prabhu Yeshu aapko changai dene wala hai?
Yes.
Jesus is going to heal you, right? Jesus is going to heal you, right? Yes or no? Prabhu Yeshu, Jesus is going to heal you. प्रभु यीशु आपको चंगाई देने वाला है. इज ही गोइंग टू हील यू? देने वाला है चंगाई. नाउ माय क्वेश्चन टू यू, इज जीसस गोइंग टू हील देम? वन पीटर 2:24. ओके, अभी प्रभु यीशु का वचन देखेंगे. द वर्ड ऑफ गॉड सेज दैट बाय हिज वुंड्स यू हैव बीन healed. You have been, and what are you saying? He will heal me. Now I want to give you all of you some good news. Are you ready?
Yes.
For the last 2000 years, God has healed nobody. I said, for the last 2000 years, God has healed nobody. Are you angry with me?
No.
So if God has not healed for the last 2000 years anybody, how did people get healed? There are two reasons why people could have got healed. Listen to this. Two reasons why people could got healed. One is God's mercy. For those who don't know the truth, God's mercy. And the second one is because they believed that Jesus has already healed them. I said there are only two reasons why people have got healed: because of his mercy and because of the truth that they believed God's word. Now these sisters, they all happen to be sisters, no brothers here. Looks like the brothers have been going to the gym every day. Brother Sandeep, aapko bhi kuch rangai chahiye? Nahi. So only the sisters won. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sisters. Sorry? He doesn't seem to be wanting healing. He's like on a mobile phone. He's not in a prayer meeting. Hello? Where are you? Come, you want some prayers? Put your phone, switch off your phone. Put off your phone. Come in front. Come. So listen. If the word of God says, who himself, let's all read that. Who himself bore our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, having died to sins, might live for righteousness. Now read that. By whose stripes?
By
You were healed. By whose stripes you will be healed or you were healed? When you see, when you know that somebody is going to give you the truth right now, you were healed, correct? Because you are here, you know that you were healed. But when you are not in a prayer meeting, you need to remind yourself all the time when you're not well, you were healed, you were healed. If you were healed and you believe that, what is your response to Jesus? Not you, yours.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Agar aap Prabhu Yeshu ke vachan par sachmuch vishwas rakhte ho, suno meri baat. Agar Prabhu Yeshu ke vishwas vachan par vishwas rakhte ho, to Prabhu Yeshu ka vachan bolta hai ki uske ghaon se humko changai mil chuki hai. Milne wali nahi hai, mil chuki hai. Kabhi mil chuki hai? 2000 साल पहले. इसीलिए ये 2000 साल में प्रभु यीशु किसी को भी चंगाई नहीं दे रहे हैं. God is healing nobody because he has already healed us on the cross by taking all our sicknesses in his body. Is that right? So when you believe what he has already done, the rest of it is only to receive and thank and receive. Change your mind. Don't even think that you are sick. Just believe that you have been healed and receive it because of his love, his unconditional love, his unconditional love. See, remember, everything is connected to God's unconditional love. God so loved the world that he gave his only son so that all those who believe in him. If you believe that scripture, you receive your healing. When you believe in Jesus, you believe in his word, you receive your healing. Why you receive your healing? Because of his love. You believe God's love, you believe his promise, therefore you receive your healing. Is that right? Jab ye Prabhu Yeshu ke pyar se humko vishwas hai, tabhi ye pyar humko changai deti hai. That word of God which I'm believing is a way to receive God's love. When I believe, I receive God's love. When I receive God's love, that God's love also gives me healing. It's a healing love of God. Amen?
Amen.
Okay. So, instead of we having, let's have partners. Okay? You'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You're the odd man out now. Now you come separately. Come here. You come here. Come to my brother Yolanda. Come here. Now, you all come in front. You all come in front. Come here. You all come in front. Aage aaye. Aage aaye. Now, can you both stand? Two people stand opposite each other like this. You stand here and you stand here. Face each other. Aaye. Face each other. Face each other. You also face each other. Now, you'll pray over her. You'll pray over her. Okay? You pray over or decide who wants to pray over first. Yeah. Who first? You want to have a toss or something?
No.
Coin? No need of coin. So you all decide. Maybe all these sisters will pray over these sisters first. So you're going to be prayed over. So you all three ask these sisters, what should I pray for you for? Ask them. Okay? And then I will give you the words. Then we will start praying. Okay? So start. Come on. You tell him what you want to pray for. पूछो हम आप पूछो किस क्या है तकलीफ क्या है तब बाद में हम चालू करेंगे ओके इज दैट फाइन नाउ एवरी वन ऑफ यू नोज व्हाट इज द लॉ ऑफ फेथ द लॉ ऑफ फेथ इज स्पीकिंग बिलीविंग रिसीविंग थैंकिंग Forgiving, speaking, believing, receiving, thanking, forgiving. Hindi mein kya bolte hain usko, brother? What is the five steps?
Speaking, bolna, vishwas karna,
receiving,
grahan karna,
thanking,
dhanyavad dena,
and forgiving,
aur maafi dena.
पैसा विश्वास करने के लिए लॉ रहता है जैसा ये पांच स्टेप करेंगे
टू स्पीक टू द प्रॉब्लम, ये जो प्रॉब्लम है, बीमारी है, उसकी तरफ से बात करना है, प्रेयर नहीं करना है, बात करना है, हटाना है प्रभु यीशु के नाम से, ओके? उसके बाद जो मैं बोला है उसके ऊपर मुझे विश्वास रखना चाहिए, विश्वास रखा कि जो मैं बोला वो हो गया, तो मैं क्या करना है, मुझे उसे प्राप्त करना है, अगर प्राप्त कर दिया है, हासिल कर दिया है, तो क्या बोलना है प्रभु यीशु को, धन्यवाद करना चाहिए। और उसके बाद अगर मुझे मेरे को किसी से माफ़ी देना है, क्योंकि अगर माफ़ी नहीं दिया, किसी से किसी के साथ नाराज हूँ मैं, कोई मुझे किसी के साथ झगड़ा है, मुझे किसी को माफ़ करना है, मैंने उसको माफ़ करना है, क्योंकि अगर माफ़ नहीं किया तो जो कुछ प्रभु यीशु का मुझे ये जीवन में हासिल करना है वो कभी मैं हासिल नहीं करूँगा, क्योंकि ये जो मेरे मैं forgiveness, what is forgiveness? माफी नहीं दिया करके ये पूरा ब्लॉक रहता है, प्रभु यीशु से ब्लॉक नहीं, मैं माफी नहीं दिया करके वो सब ब्लॉक होता है, तो मुझे क्या करना पड़ेगा, माफी देना चाहिए, ओके? तो ये माफी देना, this forgiveness, let us do this prayer first, and let us all of us do that, because unforgiveness, listen everybody, unforgiveness is an ugly head that always sticks out every day. Don't you think that forgiveness is a one-time thing? Every day we have to be careful that we don't have any spirit of unforgiveness towards anybody, because that spirit of unforgiveness is going to block everything from God and give a license to the devil to kill, steal and destroy. So we have to be very careful that we don't have any unforgiveness in our life. Is that right? Amen. So let's all close our eyes. This is not only for the six sisters and for this brother, but for all of us, including me. Let's all close our eyes and say this prayer. Everyone, just close your eyes. Say this prayer with me. Loving Father. If I ask my brother Yolanda to translate that in Hindi, it'll be better. Okay. Benji. मेरी सिस्टर रिदीमा हिंदी में बोलेगी, तो आप हिंदी में बोलो, और जो इंग्लिश में बोलता है इंग्लिश में बोलो, ओके? हम माफ देने का प्रेयर कर रहे हैं, अभी माफी देने का प्रेयर कर रहे हैं, ओके? लेट्स क्लोज आवर आईज,
हम सब अपनी आंखें बंद करें और ये कहें,
हेवनली फादर,
स्वर्गीय पिता,
आई थैंक यू,
मैं आपको धन्यवाद देती हूँ,
अगर आप लोग चुप बैठेंगे ना, सुनो सुनो, ये जो प्रेयर बोल रहे हैं आपको मुंह खोल के खोल पढ़ना पड़ेगा जोर से, क्योंकि ये चुप रह के काम नहीं हो जाएगा, यू हैव टू ओपन योर माउथ एंड स्पीक योर फेथ, इफ यू कैन ओपन योर माउथ यू कैन रिसीव, फेथ मीन्स यू हैव टू ओपन योर माउथ, प्लीज ओपन योर माउथ एंड स्पीक द वर्ड, क्योंकि अगर आपको माफी चाहिए, माफी देना है, आपको मुंह खोल के बात करना पड़ेगा, ये चुपचाप रह के काम नहीं हो जाएगा, ओके? Is that fine? So let's speak it out with faith. Everybody, I'll start again. Heavenly Father,
स्वर्गीय पिता,
I thank you.
मैं आपको धन्यवाद देती हूँ.
I don't think they are praying. मैं रुक रहा हूँ. मैं जोर से बोलो ना. मुझे आवाज नहीं दे रहा है सुरेन. जोर से बोलो, बोलो, बोलो. वो इतना जोर से बोल रहे हैं. आपके लिए बोल रहे हैं वो. थोड़ा जोर से. मैं रुक रहा हूँ. रुकेगा. Heavenly Father,
स्वर्गीय पिता,
I thank you and praise you.
मैं आपको धन्यवाद देती हूँ और स्तुति देती हूँ.
For your great love for me.
आपका महान प्यार के लिए.
Heavenly Father,
स्वर्गीय पिता,
Your word says.
आपका वचन कहता है,
That when I forgive those who have hurt me,
जब मैं किसी को क्षमा देती हूँ जिसने मुझे दुख पहुंचाया है,
You forgive me.
आप मुझे क्षमा करते हैं.
Believing your word.
आपके वचन पर विश्वास रख के,
I right now forgive every person who has hurt me in my life.
I right now forgive
समय मैं हर एक इंसान को माफ करती हूँ जिसने मुझे दुख पहुँचाया है।
Lord, your word says.
परमेश्वर आपका वचन कहता है.
That when I forgive others, every block to receiving from you is removed from my path. When I forgive,
every जब मैं किसी को माफ करती हूँ,
every block to receiving from you is removed from my path.
हर एक बंधन जो मेरे जीवन में है वो टूट जाता है।
So in the name of Jesus,
तो यीशु मसीह के नाम से,
I'm speaking to that spirit of unforgiveness. I am speaking to that spirit of unforgiveness.
मैं उस अक्षमा करने की आत्मा से कहती हूँ।
Get out of my life, my family, my marriage, and every relationship.
मेरे जीवन से निकल जा, मेरे परिवार से निकल जा और मेरे हर एक संबंध से निकल जा।
In the name of Jesus.
यीशु मसीह के नाम से।
I thank you, Lord Jesus.
मैं आपको धन्यवाद देती हूँ, यीशु।
For setting me free.
आपने मुझे मुक्त किया है।
थैंक यू जीसस।
धन्यवाद यीशु।
प्रेज यू जीसस।
स्तुति हो यीशु।
आई रिसीव माय हीलिंग नाउ।
मैं मेरा चंगाई प्राप्त करती हूँ।
आई रिसीव माय मिरेकल नाउ।
मैं मेरे चमत्कार को प्राप्त करती हूँ।
I receive every blessing from you now.
मैं हर एक आशीर्वाद ग्रहण करती हूँ।
Thank you, Jesus. Come on, let's give the Lord a round of applause. Thank you, Jesus.
धन्यवाद यीशु।
Praise you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
हम मुँह खोल कर स्तुति दे। Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You know, if you believed what you just prayed. You have opened up everything to receive from heaven and kick the devil out of your life.
Amen.
I said, if you believe what you just said just now, you are opened yourself to receive everything from heaven and kick the devil out of your life now. Amen. All right? And now we're just going to pray for that physical healing, and it is a matter of just receiving that healing. Amen. So close your eyes, both of you. If you can, the first three, the sisters on this side, on my left, are going to pray for this sister. So aap aankhe band karo, sister, when we pray for Hindi. Okay. Close your eyes and lay your hands upon the other sister, on her head, on her shoulder, wherever you want. Okay. Close your eyes. Aankhe band rakhiye. Loving Father.
Premal Yeshu.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
यीशु क्रिस्त के नाम से,
I take my authority.
मैं मेरा अधिकार लेती हूँ.
And I speak to that spirit of infirmity.
मैं उस उस बीमारी की आत्मा से कहती हूँ,
You spirit of infirmity, in the name of Jesus, get out of this body.
तू बीमारी की आत्मा, इस शरीर से निकल जा.
In the name of Jesus, I bind you, I curse you, and command you to get out of this body.
यीशु मसीह के नाम से मैं तुझे बांधती हूँ, तुझे श्राप देती हूँ और तुझसे कहती हूँ इस शरीर से निकल जा.
और इन राइट नाउ माय डियर सिस्टर, यू आर सेट फ्री ऑफ दैट स्पिरिट ऑफ इन्फर्मिटी इन द नेम ऑफ जीसस.
और इस समय मैं कहती हूँ आप बहन पूरी तरह मुक्त हो उस बीमारी से.
And now,
और अभी,
I claim Psalm 22 verse 14.
मैं भजन संगीता 22वां अध्याय 14वां वचन कहती हूँ.
Your word says that all your bones were out of joint.
आपका वचन कहता है कि आपके हर एक हड्डी जोड़ों से अलग थी.
All your bones were out of joint.
आपका हर एक हड्डी जोड़ों से अलग थी.
So in the name of Jesus.
और इसीलिए यीशु मसीह के नाम से.
I command all your bones to receive healing now.
मैं आपके हर एक हड्डियों से कहती हूँ कि चंगाई प्राप्त कर.
I speak to all the bones, muscles, ligaments, tissues.
मैं इस समय हर एक हड्डी से कहती हूँ, हर एक चमड़े से कहती हूँ, हर एक जोड़ों से कहती हूँ, चंगा हो जा.
बोलिए.
मैं कहती हूँ हर एक हड्डी, हर एक चमड़ा, हर एक मसल, हर एक जोड़ चंगा हो जा.
In the name of Jesus.
यीशु मसीह के नाम से.
By the power of the Holy Spirit.
पवित्र आत्मा के सामर्थ से.
I command.
मैं अधिकार लेती हूँ.
All the pain in your body to leave now.
हर एक दर्द को इस शरीर से निकल जा.
I claim Hebrews 1:14.
मैं हीब्रू के किताब पहला अध्याय 14वां वचन ग्रहण करती हूँ.
Your word says.
आपका वचन कहता है.
That angels are ministering spirits.
कि स्वर्ग दूत यहाँ पे आपका वचन देते हैं.
Sent to minister to those who are to inherit salvation. Sent to those who are to inherit salvation. In the name of Jesus.
यीशु मसीह के नाम से.
By the power of the Holy Spirit.
पवित्र आत्मा के सामर्थ से.
I command angels.
मैं स्वर्ग दूत को अधिकार लेके कहती हूँ.
To go now.
जा इस समय.
And bring forth brand new part in the sister's body.
और एक नया शरीर का टुकड़ा लेके आ यीशु मसीह के नाम से.
And by the power of the Holy Spirit.
पवित्र आत्मा के सामर्थ से.
Receive your healing and miracle now.
इस समय आपके चमत्कार को, आपके चंगाई को ग्रहण करो.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
धन्यवाद पवित्र आत्मा.
For this quick surgery.
कि आपने बहुत जल्दी से इस सर्जरी को किया है.
Thank you, Holy Spirit, for setting the sister completely free.
धन्यवाद पवित्र आत्मा कि आपने इस बहन को पूरी तरह मुक्त किया है.
In Jesus' name, Amen.
यीशु मसीह के नाम से. Amen.
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 Now, sisters who have been prayed over, check your body. Check your body. Gone? Come on. Come on. Tell us. Tell us. Tell us what happened.
I had an accident in the month of October. It was a very small accident which turned out to be major. and I was operated on the 10th. The operation turned out to be very, very major and deep. I had put it on the prayer group also. And after about 2.5 months, it healed. There also there is a miracle, because when I was operated on the 10th, it was a Thursday. And I was told that to come back on Saturday and I will be sutured, because it was not sutured at that minute. It was left open because the doctor was suspecting that the wound will get infected again. And Thursday morning I was operated. This was on 10th of October. I came back home. I rested for that couple of hours. Evening, I came for my regular evening mass. The same thing I did on Friday. And somehow, because of not being treated very well at the doctor's for the surgery, I had a very funny fear in me on Thursday. And when I came for Friday mass on evening, I just said one thing to Jesus: I know that you're going to heal me, and I'm not going to have sutures the next day done on me. I went back with the very high spirit that being healed already. And next morning I was going to the doctor, supposed to be sutured and get my wound dressed at the same time. And Teresa happened to call me from our prayer group as I was on my way to the doctor, asking me if I will need anyone to accompany me to the doctor's, because I was alone. I just told her, no, I am quite fine. And I even told her this, that I won't be having sutures done on my leg. And she was like, are you sure? I said, yes, I am very sure, because I'm healed. And this was a message which was whispered to me in my ear the previous night, because that thing was playing on my mind. And as I came for evening mass on Friday, I had just thanked the Lord, because I had that faith in Him that I would be fine. Saturday morning, I went for my dressing according to me, but according to the doctor, I was coming for my sutures to be done. And it was quite a deep cut. It was a three-corner cut which he had made on my knee, wherein I could even, you know, see the joint, the kneecap joint. When I went to him and he opened the dressing, he just stood with his hand on his chin and he asked me, how did this happen? Believe me, it was completely, the flesh had covered completely, and it was only a raw flesh on top, and it was only waiting for the skin to join back. I did not need any, not even one suture. After all that, it took about, since it was quite raw and deep, it took a while to heal, but I was very confident and I knew, with my God, there is nothing impossible. I went through the procedure of the healing, and it did heal. It is dry. You can see it. But unfortunately, I was having a swelling. The swelling is constant on my leg right from that time, and pain. And for some good reason, I just thought I'll go and get it checked, because I was having a problem in walking. And because of that, the strain was coming on my left leg, and behind my left knee, I started getting a swelling. So just to be on the safe side, I went to the doctor, and doctor happens to tell me that in the same knee, the ligament is torn, but he's not very sure that whether the ligament is torn because of the accident or because of the surgery, because the doctor, the way he did the surgery, he treated me like one buffalo, a total animal, because he didn't even want to, when he started the surgery, he didn't even give me a local anesthesia. He started it straight away. Till I did not scream with pain, then he realized that he has to give me a local anesthesia. So, you know, when I showed it, I was told to take an MRI. This happened on Thursday again. I think Thursday is a very bright day for me. But Thursday morning again, Thursday afternoon again, doctor tells me that I need to take an MRI. And after the MRI, we can decide that whether the ligament is torn because at time of accident or time of surgery. And then he said that I can take time to do the surgery, but he has asked me that, he's told me that I'll have to get a surgery done again on the same knee to reinstruct the ligament. As usual, I come for my evening mass, and I just looked at Jesus. that day I was feeling, when I was walking into the compound, first time I had tears in my eyes. But the minute when I walked into the church and I saw the Blessed Sacrament right in front of me, I was like, are you serious? Do you have tears in your eyes for what? You know, and I asked myself that question. I went up as usual, I said my prayer. When I met my son in the evening, because my son was with me when I went to the doctor, I told him, I said, no MRI, no nothing. I said, okay, benefit of doubt, I'll take the MRI, but no surgery is going to be done on me. He said, Mama, are you joking? Why are you wanting to play the fool with your health? I said, no, I'm healed already. I know that Jesus is going to heal me, and I'm healed already, and I'm praising and thanking him already. That the next day I met sister outside the church. That was on a Friday. I met her outside the church and I was talking to her. That evening she called me. She called me and I used to have a lot of pain. But I knew that, you know what, by the time I have to go in for my surgery, doctor's going to be telling me, you know what, you don't require the surgery because the ligament is, there is a time that, you know, the ligaments generally join together. And I have this confidence that it would happen to me also. I was very, very confident about it. That same evening, sister called me and she said, she sent me a healing prayer actually. She sent me a healing prayer. I just finished saying that prayer and she happened to call me. She called me and she says, no, I got a message saying that you sent the message, but instead of sending the message, it's better that you pray with her. And she prayed with me. I had my knee on my hand on my knee. At the end of the prayer, I felt a very hot sensation in my leg. And 90% of the pain was gone. 90% of the pain was gone. As usual, I came to church again. And my everything is either the crucifix or the Blessed Sacrament. Those are my only two, everything in my life. And I again sat in front of the Blessed Sacrament. I closed my eyes. I felt like I was frozen. I was totally frozen. And when my eyes were closed, I felt like one white cover right around me. There was a white cover right around me. And I felt like, no, I am, you know, this is something very strange, something very, I don't think I've ever experienced it before. And when I opened my eyes, I had no pain. And this morning, I used the kneecap only for the sake of, because doctor has mentioned that I have to use it. But as I was praying, I've rumored it and I've given it to my son. I told him, keep it in your bag and I don't need it. And being honest, I did, you know what, devils tempts your mind. It puts things to you even when you don't feel it. I went home during the lunch break just now and came back. And since I walked up that steep, I did feel a little pain, but I think that was only imagination. But now I don't have any pain. I'm able to bend my leg, which I was not able to bend before.
Praise God. Hallelujah. So now, dear sister, it's your turn to pray over her. Are you ready? Okay, any healing? Who's there here? She's gone to washroom. So how are you, sister? Kya hua? So you're set free. Okay. So shall we wait for her to come? Okay. You have to be prayed over. Sorry, ma'am. You don't have any healing. You don't require healing. How are you? Sorry, you got prayed over. What happened? What you were praying for? Kya problem tha?
Stomach ache.
Gaya. Sachmuch gaya. Abhi stomach ache nahi hai. Pakka. Pakka. Very good. Can we give the Lord a round of applause? She had a stomach pain. This sister was unwell. This sister had a pain in the leg. Do you see how easy it was? Was it difficult? And we have not prayed. Those sisters who did not even pray any time before, they used their hands and prayed and they have seen God's glory. Amen? Okay, before we have this, she requires prayers, right? Is she coming? Okay, we'll start, then we can pray over her later, okay? We'll start. Now you pray over her. Close your eyes and pray. Loving Father, in the name of Jesus, I'm speaking to that spirit of infirmity. in my sister's body. You spirit of infirmity, in the name of Jesus, I bind you, I curse you, and I rebuke you, and cast you out of the sister's body. In the name of Jesus, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, you, my dear sister, are completely set free from that infirmity, from that pain, from that discomfort, in the name of Jesus. And now, by the power of the Holy Spirit, I claim Psalm 22:14. Your word says, all your bones were out of joint, and by virtue of the pain you bore in your body, my dear sister, receive your healing now. I speak to all your bones, muscles, ligaments, tissues, cartilages, tendons, nerves, be loose now, relaxed and released by the power of the Holy Spirit. I command every part of your body to be lubricated by the power of the Holy Spirit. I also claim Hebrews 1:14, where your word says, angels are ministering spirits sent to minister to those who are to inherit salvation. My dear sister, in the name of Jesus, you are to inherit healing now. Angels, go now and bring forth brand new parts in my sister's body, which have been affected, which have been damaged by the spirit of infirmity. By the power of the Holy Spirit, receive your healing now. Receive your creative miracle now. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, Holy Spirit, that as I speak now, every part of my sister's body is completely healed and restored. I thank you and praise you for all this, Father. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Finish. Operation is done. Come on, check it out, sister. Come on, check it out. What pain you had. Come on, check it out. Check out your pain. What?
It's become less.
It's become less. Can you start taking a walk up to there and just say, thank you, Jesus. Take two quick, brisk walk. Brisk walk. Come on. I don't want you to catch anything now. Come on. Brisk walk. Thank you, Jesus. Open your mouth and keep thanking the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Come on. Turn back. Piche mood. Thank you, Jesus. Come on. Take a round and come. Take a round. Don't come back that side. Take a round. Take a round. Take a round. Thank you, Jesus. Keep saying thank you, Jesus. Come on. Let's all thank the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for healing and setting my sister completely. Sister, I want you to start marching like a soldier. Come on, up, down, up, down. Full force, full force. Come on, faster. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Sister, can you increase your speed? You are catching something. Now you are walking. The Lord is... Come on, can you march like this? Can you lift your leg? Up, down, up, down. Full force, full force. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. One last round. One last round. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for setting my sister completely free. You don't heal 80%, 90%, but you heal 100%. Every pain I cast out, I command healing and complete restoration in the name of Jesus. Amen. Where is your pain now?
Say that loudly.
Gone. 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 Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, what about you, sister? Boliye.
Thoda acha lag raha hai.
Thoda acha lag raha hai. Kya hua tha? Aiyye, aiyye. Idhar aiyye. Idhar aiyye. She says, acha lag raha hai. Humko acha lagna ye pasand nahi hai. Prabhu Yeshu ko acha lagna pasand hai. Prabhu Yeshu ko chahiye ki puri changai ho gayi hai. Hai ki nahi? Okay, hold this.
Hold this.
Loosed of your infirmity. So in the name of Jesus, my dear sister, be loosed now. Be loosed now.
be loose now. In Jesus' name.
Amen. अभी देखिए कुछ करो, अभी थोड़ा म्यूजिक लगा देंगे, चलो थोड़ा फास्ट मारो, देखो अभी कैद नहीं कर सकते, थोड़ा अभी मकर ना करिए हमारे लिए, करो ना,
हो गया
सचमुच अभी अच्छा लग रहा है और पूरा चंगाई हो गई है, बस वेरी गुड. कैन वी गिव द लॉर्ड अ राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज. वी ओनली हैव टू रिसीव आवर हीलिंग. This is paining, that is paining, all pain's gone. Okay, what about you? She has to be prayed over. Okay, can you pray over a sister? What is your...
Your stomach pain, who got healed of stomach pain? Are you coming? See, two people got healed of stomach pain. You pray over, come on, close.
Now say this, Father, you have no favorites. You have no partiality. Just as you healed me of my stomach pain, heal this dear sister of mine of her stomach pain. So in the name of Jesus, you spirit of infirmity, you stomach pain, in the name of Jesus, get out of her body. Out, out, stomach pain out, in the name of Jesus. By the power of the Holy Spirit, you spirit of infirmity, I bind you, I curse you and command you to leave her body now, and I set you free of every infirmity, of every pain, in Jesus' name. And now, by the power of the Holy Spirit, I command healing to all the parts of your body in the name of Jesus. Hebrews 1:14 says, angels are ministering spirits sent to minister to those who are to inherit salvation. My dear sister, you are to inherit healing now. Therefore, angels, go now and replace all the parts of our body which are in pain, which are affected, which are damaged by the spirit of infirmity. I thank you, Holy Spirit, for setting her completely free. I thank you, angels, for changing all her parts, replacing with new parts. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for this quick surgery and setting her completely free. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Now check your pain. Come on, check your pain. Where is your pain? Where is your pain?
Gone.
Sure it is gone. Gone with the wind. Two people had got stomach pain opposite each other. See how they were lined up. Stomach pain gone. In the name of Jesus. Is it difficult? Now if we pray, I only prayed the word. If we learn the word and we know how to pray, can we not pray over so many people? My sister Antonia prayed over this sister 90%. The remaining 5% what she could do here. Correct? And so many people have been given the word by one another. If we can go out and lay our hands, do you need us? Do you need us? Or you can do the job? How many hands God has given us? Two. So let's start using our hands from today. Lay our hands in the name of Jesus. First and foremost, rebuke the sickness, curse it, command it to leave, and then command healing in the name of Jesus. That's all. It's so simple. Because of what? The love of God. God loves us. When you believe His word, you receive His healing love and you are set free. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, so we close today. Tomorrow we'll be here by 11 o'clock. Our session starts by 12. Okay? So come here by 10:30 because Father will expose the Blessed Sacrament at 10:30. Tomorrow happens also to be a special day. One of our team members is a special day. So we will have also another cake cutting tomorrow. And how many of you are going to bring someone else tomorrow? For the cake and for everything. And for the lunch also. And for the word also. How many of you are going to promise to bring somebody, at least one person? Nobody intends to go and call somebody? Praise God. So let's close our eyes. Let's end up with a closing prayer. Let's close it with a closing prayer. My brother Yolanda is leading us in a prayer.
Father God, we thank you for this time that we had. Lord, thank you for your word that was shared. Thank you for filling us with your love, showing us your truth, showing us your glory, Lord. Oh, Father, we are so excited to know more about you. Thank you for teaching us daily how to live a victorious life. Oh, Holy Spirit, teach us and lead us to Jesus. Teach us more and more truth through all our brothers and sisters, those who are preaching the word, and equip us so that we can go out and proclaim God's word. Oh, Heavenly Father, we are ready to do your will. No matter what is our weaknesses, we put aside, but we are ready to do your will. We are ready to go out, we are ready to move out, we are ready to share your love. Oh, Father, fill us, let our cup overflow. This is our prayer today and the rest of our life. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
So thank you, brothers and sisters. Good night and see you all tomorrow. Tomorrow is another exciting day and we're going to have our session from 11 to 6 o'clock. Okay? So God bless you. Good night and see you all tomorrow.